like Tim said, I am a bookmaker. I actually in undergrad, I printmaking, papermaking, bookmaking. After I graduated from undergrad, I stopped working in sketchbooks because my painting teacher and my printmaking teacher forced us to do it, and I hated it. So for a whole year after I graduated, I was like, I'm not doing anything in a sketchbook. And then I didn't make any art. So I forced myself to work back in the sketchbook, and I started making more books, and I started thinking about like what kind of books I can make. I'm actually not like an artistic bookmaker. I take recycled books. I go to thrift stores, I go to estate sales, and I reuse and repurpose books. And that has gotten me to where I am today. I'm really nervous, sorry.
Did you say that you are not an artistic bookmaker, but you take odds and ends from other books and then create your own from it?
Yes, yeah, so I'll just take like...
Well, what's wrong? Give me that power back.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Well, I went to a bookmaking thing at Pinland School of Crafts, and I did medieval bookbinding. And the books that they are making are like architectural structure wonders, and like I'm not that type of bookmaker. But I've always worked in sketchbooks since that point when like I completely stopped making art. So it was like I have to be a bookmaker that still uses my ideas in my sketchbooks. And I do use it as a diary. Like I've restrained myself with that book.
That's fair.
Yeah. I was like really scared. I was like, people are gonna read this. I don't want to read this. But I work constantly from my sketchbook, from my work back and forth. Working on ideas, color shapes. I sometimes like I just like my sketchbook, and I just want to keep that as like a beautiful little tome. I've always looked back at like Frida Kahlo's sketchbook. I don't know if y'all have seen that, but like I think about that, and like, to me, that's like her everlasting master artwork, even though it was nothing like what she actually produced. That's basically it. So I don't know what else to say. Like Tim and like Deb, I'm also a teacher. This year, I started working in oil pastel. Never done it before. I never did it with my students. And now, like, I feel comfortable after playing in my sketchbook, doing it in big work. Now, like, my students just did some oil painting drawings, and like that was like really like hopeful for me. For like, okay, if I can learn something new, I can just pass it on to my kids. And they really enjoyed it. So.
I was going to ask you how you went from bookbinding to pastel.
Because I am a multitasker. Yeah, I mean, I like to do sculptures. I sew. I use a lot of vintage fabrics for books and for. In the past, I made like these pillows that I stacked up and painted, and like I'm like a Jill of all trades, I guess. I dabble. I'm not a master in anything yet.
I've seen Amanda's pillow sculptures, and they're like all tied off, like Christo and Jean Claude, and they're very fun to look at. And so I think about that work and your sketchbook and your pieces that are on the wall, they all have a sense of this form and a softness. And I think
they're like really restrained too, like with the pillows, like they're like constricted.
And yeah, they're tight.
And then when I go into my drawings, like I will try to contort them. And make them like, fit into the space, which I still don't understand why I'm doing that.
Well, there's some kind of fluidity there, though, with some of the pieces that fold back, and then there's pieces that they feel soft, they feel rounded, and the colors are warm.
And like the textures on it, kind of. These not as much, but the ones in the past when I was painting, like, I'm not a painter. Like, I want to be a painter, but I'm not a painter. I would try to do textures and like stuff that look like work, but I think I found oil pastel is the key, because I like the movement and the fluidity of my hand on the paper, or even like, I'm like a big stickler about waste. Like, I don't want to make art, because I don't want to waste it and like let the earth take care of it. So I've been like using like old canvases that I found. Here's an old rug, so it's like an old rug that I cut up and started using. So I'm trying to do more upcycled, like my books. So.
Yeah, it's too bad you guys can't touch these, because some of them you can.
I don't care.
because to me you might not want to touch them. But some of them are very soft and they move, and it was really hard for me to pin down all the corners because I loved the motion. And Amanda came in and she was like, can you put pins around
I was afraid that they were just
going to flatten out, right? Which I understand, but like, if you look at the one in the back here, you can see how much the canvas moves, and it moves with the work. And so that movement, that condensing, you know, you're saying, you're condensing the work, and you can see that with the medium that you're using for the pastels. So anyway,
yeah. this one's not bad. I don't mind. I like all the holes and the rips and tears and the stuff that I accidentally
did. Any mistake is not a mistake.
I feel like some of them look like ancient sort of fertility figures, and some of them have like a puzzle piece product to them. I mean, are you referencing things? Are they more out of like sort of just drawing out probably in a sketchbook and then you see them?
I mean, I reference body parts, I reference like when I fold up and stuff like that, but I also have like a huge love of archaeology. So, like, I do have like, studied and researched a lot about old days, so that always comes back. And a lot of these, like if you look through my sketchbooks recently, they kind of look like a Mayan alphabet, or like they could be like finished alphabet because like they're just completely gestural, like squish shapes, like.
Yeah. I could totally see that reference in the shapes, but they're almost like a little bit inflated.
Mm-hmm.
Bulbous, but they're kind of like bulbous shapes. And I love the reference to skin rolls.
Yeah, definitely skin roll references. Yeah.
In relation to that, just the two that are near me, you have one that has that very inflated quality to it, and the one right above it pulls away and it has a flatness. Like literally,
they're just so.
You have one that's like that almost has that goldfish cracker quality to it, and it has a wider depth to it, and it kind of goes back.
I do a lot of like diptychs, kind of like on your triptych and diptychs, like stuff that's all similar, and then I'll abandon that idea and move on through working through my skin.
How did the oil pastels work for you, like on kind of that semi unusual surface?
Like the rug? I did buy some oil sticks too, like from this, like. Concrete place or something, like we were supposed to be able to write on anything, so I ordered black, white, and pink, and like I used those, and then I would go back in with some other oil pastels and kind of melt, like push them in there.
Interesting.
But I use my phone and limit all that stuff, so like it's like really digging into it and hurting myself. I tried using other tools, but my hands are the best.
Yeah, sometimes your hands are the best.
Just much. So I don't know what I'm gonna do. I do want to do more sculptures. I don't have space for it though. I want to do like huge.
Get up to Salem Artworks.
Yeah.
It's close by.
Yeah.
A lot of accessibility.
Yeah. I think they've had residency spots available as recently. Wait, did they post it here? Mm-hmm. Place?
There's a residence. They're looking for artists.
Yeah. We do have a family friend who's dating somebody in that.
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing some of these pillows and other sculptures. And do you have a website for your books for binding?
I have an Etsy, and then I have my Instagram. I got rid of my website because I just didn't keep up with it.
Yeah.
But right now I just have some hand, like, because I'll do just covers for my, like, paint covers, do that stuff, and then do recycle. I just finished a sketchbook for a friend who lives in Oregon, Seattle, Washington, for his restaurant that he owns. He like wanted to do a guest book, so I customized something for him. Nice. I've done a lot of wooden books that I really enjoy doing. I always do the same stitch though. I don't really vary my stitch.
What's your Etsy account?
It's Amanda Mike Harris.
Ah, there you go.
Yeah, but I don't. It's on my Instagram page, so if you don't mind that.
Well, we all have an Etsy page. We have to catch up with it.